Hello everyone and welcome to Learning with Spekteacher. For those of you who have watched my previous videos on my channel, you'll be familiar with the one I created last year surrounding the events of Stardust, a British South American Airways plane that left a mysterious Morse code before crashing into the Andes Mountains. If you haven't watched that video, make sure to check it out before watching this one. Anyway, after making that video, I decided that it's time I take my channel in a whole new direction, and what better date to do that than April the 1st? No more mysteries, no more true crime, and certainly no more monoliths. Instead, it's now time for Learning with Spekteacher. So, we all know what Stendek may or may not have meant now, but how about we actually learn something a little bit more useful? How about we learn how to communicate in Morse code? Well, let's start with the basics. Morse code is made up of dots, which are short tones, and dashes, which are long tones. These dots and dashes can be combined in numerous ways to make different letters or numbers, which can subsequently create words and sentences. Every letter of the alphabet is represented by a unique combination of these dots and dashes, and I'll show you how to easily memorize each and every one using verbal mnemonics. So let's start with the letter A. A is created using the combination dot dash. And an easy way to remember this is by sounding out the word along. If you say the word out loud, the first syllable of the word is quite short, like the dot. And the second part is, well, quite literally, long. By associating this word with this letter, you should be able to memorize this easier when you want to hear Morse code in the future, or want to remember how to telegraph it yourself. So, now you understand how these mnemonics work. Let's go through the rest. B is Bob is the man. C is Coca-Cola. Just double check it for thallium before you use it. D is dog did it. E is straightforward as it's just a single dot, so you can remember this with just the word I. F is fetch a fireman. Yeah, some of these are a bit strange, I'll be honest, but trust me, it will help you remember. G is good morning. With H, just think of someone laughing. Ha 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 ha. Or maybe even ho 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 if it's Christmas time. I is iPad or iPod, maybe, for those of us who remember. Those were the days. Now, J is a tricky one, but the way I remember this is that when you land on that Monopoly square with the policeman, which I swear is every time when I play it.
Put yourself back in jail! Oh. Put yourself back! Only say it one more time.
No, I'm getting angry with all-
You end up in jail, jail, jail. I know, not the best example, but if you've got a better one, then let me know in the comments. K is kangaroo. L is Los Angeles, where a certain jetpack man is from. M is moo moo. N is actually the reverse combination to A. Navy. The way I remember O is really easy. It's literally just Janice's catchphrase from Friends. Okay, with P, I'm going to admit I've improvised a little bit here, but I've got two options, so hear me out. An aeroplane, just like the Stardust, or you could use Penelope, like the puppet from Thunderbirds, I guess. Q is very British, God save the Queen, which I always read out to the tune of Here Comes the Bride for some reason. R is rotation. S is sip, sip, sip. Maybe try to imagine drinking a hot tea. Speaking of tea, the letter T is literally just a dash. So I use the word time. U is underwear. V is for verb, is how I best remember V. W is the World War.
During a war.
X before Y is how I've learned to remember X, but I've heard other people use X marks the spot, though I don't think the syllables match up correctly with the method. Anyway, I'll leave it up to you. Y is you're a young man. And finally, Z, or Z, is zoology. So there you go. Now you have all the letters you need to create and interpret words in Morse code. Here's a practice one for you. What does this Morse code say? I'll give you a few seconds. That's right, subscribe. A totally random word I chose there with no hidden agenda whatsoever. But well done if you managed to decipher that one.
No, I'm deadly serious. Just subscribe. Just do it. Just do it right now. Just click the button. Just click the button.
Here's a few other popular or well-known phrases in Morse code. That one was SOS, which is the internationally recognized Morse code for a distress signal. If you ever need help or are in danger and you're only able to communicate through dots and dashes, using this combination will be understood in any language by anyone who can understand Morse code. Actually, now's probably a good time to point out that you can communicate Morse code through sight as well as sound. Using something like a lamp or a flashlight, you can switch it on and off to generate the letters the same way you would with sound. Here's what SOS would look like visually. Okay, how about this one? If you're a 90s child like me, you'll probably remember your first phone having that text message tone. Well, that actually spells out the phrase SMS, which stands for Short Message Service, commonly known as texting. Who knew?
Who would have thought?
Not me.
Here's a final one that you may find interesting. On the 18th of July 1965, Commander Jeremiah Denton was piloting an A6A intruder jet whilst leading a 28-aircraft bombing mission in North Vietnam. The plane suffered severe damage during the assault, and Denton was forced to eject from his plane to avoid certain death. Upon landing in the city of Than Hoa, he was quickly captured by the North Vietnamese and held in captivity as a prisoner of war with other American POWs. During his time behind bars, Denton and his fellow countrymen suffered extreme torture at the hands of his captives, at one point being forced to march down the streets of Hanoi with 50 other American POWs to be publicly beaten and abused by angry mobs. On the 2nd of May 1966, Denton was forced to take part in an interview by a visiting Japanese reporter who wanted to find out firsthand what the treatment of American soldiers was like in these Vietnamese prisons. With North Vietnamese soldiers present during the filming, Denton knew he couldn't be completely honest about his suffering, as it would result in his message being blocked and ultimately risk his life. Instead, Denton decided to communicate one single secret word in Morse code whilst answering the interviewer's questions, one which would eventually lead to the world learning the truth. As Denton spoke, he simultaneously blinked seven letters in Morse code to create the word torture, in the hopes that someone back home would be able to interpret his coded message and inform the world of his suffering. And that is exactly what happened. People began to learn of the torment and treatment of American POWs and protested to put an end to their pain, eventually leading to the end of their torture. Denton was eventually released after 8 years behind bars and promoted to Rear Admiral upon returning to his homeland for his courageous and heroic efforts during his time in captivity. So there you have it. If you're ever in a spot of trouble or you just want to impress your friends, you now have a quick and easy way of communicating in Morse code. That's it for today's episode of Learning with Spektator, Spekteacher. Today is April the 1st, 2022. I'll see you on the next one.